Hey guys, today I'm going to show you the Sony Super Audio CD SCD-1. This was built in 2000 to introduce the Sony Super Audio CD format. This one retailed for $5,000 back in the day. I wanted to show you guys what it looks like before this unit dies, because Sony has stopped making parts for it. So it's very unfortunate that once it's dead, it's going to be a doorstop. So just like the 777 I showed you a while ago, this is actually a step above that. So the difference is, of course, the color. This one's silver and the 777 is black. The side here is actually turquoise blue. It's painted, so it's really nice. This weighs in about, I think it's like 60 or 70 pounds also. As you can see, the blue here. This is the top loader, just like the 777. The main difference is that this one has an extra feet at the bottom in the center. I'm not sure you can see that. Well, maybe not. So these feet. There's another one in the center, and also the digital and analog power supply are different. And this one has the XLR outputs. So again, this unit uses a balancer for the CD, two CD lenses. The CD itself moves instead of the lens. Each CD lens, one's for standard CD and the other one is for Super Audio CD. So I want to show you guys this. Again, this one is not very fast. So once you load the CD, it takes a while for the disc to play. It's quite slow, so it reads the table of content, and then it'll tell you how many tracks are on the CD. You can also select from CD or SACD disc, and then there's your transport functions, and you have your filters, digital output, CD text, and then of course the time display. So I'm going to put the camera on a tripod and show you guys what it looks like from the back. Of course, I'm going to power it off first, unplug it, and I'm going to try to spin this guy around without hurting myself. It's very heavy. As you can see, look at all the aluminum on this thing. All right. So we have quite a few inputs and outputs. We have your balanced XLR, and then you have your unbalanced outputs. The balanced output on off switch, command mode, which links. If you have two of these players, you don't want the remote control to be confused which one you want to control. So you can do CD1 or CD2. And then standard or custom, what that does is that if you don't have a system that's high resolution, you want to switch it to standard, because Super Audio CD exceeds the frequency range of human ears. So, but setting it to custom won't really hurt the system. This was built in January 2000. You have your coaxial and digital output, optical output, and then you got your IEC connector. This was made in Japan. You can see where it's made in. There it is. It's made in Japan. As you can see, it's a pretty serious machine. So I'm happy to be able to own one. And like I said earlier, the only difference between this and the 777ES that I showed you last time is the color, the extra feet in the middle, the balanced XLR. outputs and the extra feed, analog and digital power supplies. So I think that makes a bit of a difference, actually, mainly the power supply. The balance outputs are not really true balance because this machine is not a true balance machine. But, you know, if you have a need to run extra long cables, the balance XLR output is a plus. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Please subscribe if you'd like to see more. And we'll see you guys again next time. Thanks.